This is chapter 29 of the Nowhere Emporium, and it is called Stolen. It is set in Edinburgh in July 1897. Michelle Sharp giggled as she walked arm in arm with Lucian through the Emporium's growing number of corridors. "What have you made for me this time?" she said. "It cannot be more beautiful than the Crystal Lake." Lucian allowed himself a smile. He had created a new wonder for Michelle every evening since they had met. One door led to a room made entirely from a velvet smooth chocolate. Another revealed a trek through the branches of an enormous Christmas tree, the aromas of roasting goose, spiced mincemeat, and coal dust dancing in the air. It had taken him all evening to create the music mine, a vast chasm dotted with brightly coloured jewels that filled the air with beautiful melodies when they were plucked from the walls. Lucian led her up a staircase to a solitary door. "What is it?" she asked. "Open it and find out," he said. She reached for the handle, opened the door, and took a few hesitant steps into the room beyond. "It's a garden," she said, barely able to speak through her amazement. She was right. It was a garden, an overgrown wilderness of plants and flowers and trees, but every petal of every flower was made of fire. The world inside this impossible room was dark, lit only by the flicker from the flaming plants, blues and greens, reds, yellows, oranges. "It's a fire garden," said Lucian. "I thought of you when I made it." He blushed as she turned and stared into his grey eyes. "It's perfect," she whispered, and she began to wander around the garden. Lucian watched. "You can touch the flames if you like. They won't burn." Michelle reached up, touching her fingertips to the flaming blossom of a tree. Burning cinders fell to the ground, but her skin did not burn, and she laughed and stared around like a child. "I have a surprise for you," Lucian said. "Another surprise." He took her arm, led her through an archway of creeping ivy to a clearing surrounded by apple trees, each apple a ball of softly glowing fire. In the centre of the clearing sat a table loaded with food. Lucian pulled out a chair for Michelle, keeping a keen eye on her as she sat. "Is something the matter?" he asked. "You look a little sad." She shook her head and smiled. "How could I be sad in a place like this?" Then she nodded to the feast. "May I try something? It all looks so delicious." They began to eat, talking, as they loved to do, about running away together to desert islands and exotic cities where nobody would ever find them. "Another drink?" said Michelle, and she stood and poured two large glasses of wine, handing one to Lucian. She raised her glass to you, Lucian, and your wondrous emporium. Lucian clinked his glass against hers and took a long sip of the wine. He knew something was wrong at once. The garden began to spin and blur around him. A distant echoing ring filled his head, and he saw nothing but blurred streaks of fire. He dropped his glass and it shattered on the grass, wine spilling like blood. Lucian grasped at the table as the corners of his vision faded to black. The darkness began to close in around him. He was falling. The last thing he saw before he hit the floor was Michelle, his broken vision fragmenting her face into many pieces. He reached out for her. She did nothing but watch. Lucian was wakened by a slow, rhythmic pounding in his head. He screwed up his eyes to the surrounding fire plants, grabbed hold of the table and hoisted himself up. He did not know how long he had been unconscious. Every bit of him ached. The table lay as he remembered. There were finished plates of food and Michelle's wine glass lay empty beside her plate. Lucian's glass popped and snapped beneath his feet as he stumbled around. Nothing made sense. What had happened? Where was Michelle? The mist in his mind began to thin. A thought struck him. Dread choked him as he reached slowly into his coat pocket, to the place he kept the Book of Wonders. His fingers found nothing but material. His pocket was empty. More to the point, someone had emptied it. Michelle was gone. She had taken the Book of Wonders with her.